Paramahamsa Nityananda, a rare living incarnation, is named among the world's 100 most spiritually influential personalities today. Paramahamsa Nityananda has been placed alongside Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind Body Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian, and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment. He is the 293rd pontiff of the world's most ancient Hindu organization, Madurai Adinam. Nityanandaya swagatam, anandanubhavaswadam, sarvaroganivarakam, vande papavinashaktam, nityanandaya swagatam, nityamuktam nirvikalpam, dhyanaloka pradipakam, vande shantam.
सदाशिवसमारंभां ज्ञानसम्बन्धाचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परा संयम टेक्नोलॉजी थ्रू विच द एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी एक्सपीरियंसेस एंड पावर्स विच आर इन योर कॉन्शियसनेस is expressed through your body and mind to the world is samyama. Please understand. Your consciousness is all powerful, all knowing, all pervading. But preparing your body and mind to radiate and express some of those great experiences and expressions, some of those great all pervading, all knowing experiences and expressing those powers through your body and mind, that technology is what I call samyamaha. Samyama is the applied science of pure yoga science. See, in science there is two part. One, pure science, like a theory of gravity, theory of relativity. All this is pure science. Applied science means using those laws, theories in practical life. Samyama is applied science. Applied science brings value to pure science. Samyama is the technology, the science, where all these great extraordinary powers from your consciousness is experienced and expressed to the world through your body and mind. Samyama is the essence of Hindu tradition. Understand? It is the core of Vedic tradition. See, your body has a basic infrastructure. Now, by doing weightlifting, yoga, you can prepare the body to a basic strength. Then use that basic strength to do extraordinary workout and extraordinary achievements, like a weightlifting Guinness record level or running Guinness record level, you can achieve that. You are having your mind also, you can do that. You have your mind as a basic infrastructure. And you can prepare it with samyama and achieve the extraordinary thing like enlightenment. Just understand this body and mind comparison. You have a body, you can do yoga and create a basic strength. Then you can go for the extraordinary achievements like a heavy weightlifting and do Guinness record. Same way in the mind, you have a mind, you can prepare it with samyama and reach enlightenment.
Ramakrishna healed thousands of people. He made in the same branch two color flowers to appear, and hundreds of references are there where he materialized, healed, gave boons. All the great masters and incarnations who are expressing these great powers like a healing. See, understand. See the practicality. Just by healing people, how many thousands I made them meditate and transform their lives and live a pure spiritual life. How many thousands have been transformed by the simple the applied science power I am expressing, coming, see, getting vibhuti. It is no harm. Who is being harmed by it? Nobody is harmed. Just playfully, in few places, some padukas, some deities are giving vipudi. But see, understand how many millions are inspired because they experience levitation, they experience these extraordinary powers like a vibhuti materializing, and they are experiencing the power of being blessed with the boons. So many are transforming every day. Millions are transforming all over the world. Here I am going to explain the powers of Samyama every day as per Patanjali. Not only going to express verbally, going to express experientially the powers of Samyama. Learn this experientially. See the powers of Samyama and go to the masters only who has a capacity not just to talk, experientially show the powers of Samyama. I'll translate this word Samyama as the technology through which concentration, contemplation and experiencing the pure consciousness, where the meditator and meditated becomes one, and experiencing the extraordinary experiences and powers and expressing it to the world is Samyama. The technology through which you experience extraordinary powers and express it to the world is Samyama.
So your super conscious has all powers. It is all pervading, all knowing. Eternal. But your body and mind needs to be prepared so that it can experience and express those extraordinary experiences and powers. Please understand, there are different categories of people in the spiritual realm. Some who experienced extraordinary experiences and expressed those experiences, that's all. They are called great Vedantic enlightened masters, like Ramana Maharshi. He had one of an amazing superconscious experience through the Samyama on death. A spontaneous Samyama on death happened in him at the age of 16, and that's it. He stayed in that experience forever and gave that experience to many. There are some other masters experienced extraordinary powers and expressed only those powers to the world, like a teleporting, materializing, appearing in few places at a time. Great yogis levitating. Your body and mind is like a clay. Every day you can make as you want. All you need is just reclaim the superiority over your body and mind. It's like you have some lands in your native place which you did not bother. You were working somewhere and somebody else was trying to occupy. All the ghosts, naturally all the ice will fall on your land. But suddenly, if you decide to go there and declare and put a board, it's my land, that's it, nothing else, all the fellows will run away. Reclaim, that's all. Same way, your body is also, when you don't reclaim the tamasic devilish intellectual mind, it possesses your body. Please understand, this is the worst abusal happening to your body and mind. Reclaim it. Consciously own it. create as you want. Create yogic body, Vedic mind, yen life. Samyama is the technology of extraordinary experiences and powers. It is not just some useless beliefs. No. I'll prove the Samyama is an extraordinary science. I can give you a simple technique now for you to discover the power of Samyama. I'm initiating all of you into this technique. Just have a plate or bowl of water. Make a small dua grass or a needle to float on the water. Concentrate on it. Do samyama on it. Samyama means intensely put your awareness on that needle. After a few minutes you will see your inner space is kind of entering into a mood where the idea of you and that needle is no more separate. The idea is slowly getting dissolved. Idea is slowly getting dissolved. Please understand. At that moment, when you feel the intense oneness with that needle or a grass, give a command, move right, left, straight, down. Simply the dhruva, the grass or the needle or the object will listen to you. Vaitarana, dhyana, samadhi. Please understand. All these three put together is what we call samyama. By samyama, the knowledge is achieved. Lighting up of your consciousness happens. Understand, you are a human being with all extraordinary possibilities. That is what I call you are God living in human body. All extraordinary possibilities exist in you. Extraordinary physical and mental possibilities exist in you. Like simple training can make you float in the water, swim in the water. Same way, very simple things of the life, very simple things of the life, please understand. Very simple understandings in the life, very simple changes in the life can make you experience extraordinary experiences and powers and release it through the system. Like acquiring wealth and health, all human beings should work to acquire at least few extraordinary powers, few extraordinary experiences. Otherwise, life is waste. Life is waste. If you are not experiencing and expressing extraordinary powers, forget about it. Forget about those gurus. Extraordinary power is the landmark qualification milestone of Hindu yogic Vedantic tradition. All the masters who are remembered in Hindu yogic Vedantic traditions have expressed extraordinary powers, not just experiences alone. The experience should express in the physical realm. That's what I call powers. Just if people experience Kundalini awakening and my presence, it is expressing extraordinary experiences. That's it. But Samyama is something more than that. Samyama is not only expressing extraordinary experiences, expressing casually extraordinary powers also. If the Vibhuti is also coming, then Samyama is happening. The powers of Samyama is getting expressed.
Samyama the capacity or the power, ability to experience the extraordinary experiences and powers and then either enjoy or renounce as you want. So understand that whether to live or leave or enlighten or the experience and express the extraordinary powers of consciousness, Samyama is basic need.
Pratyaksha Pada Puja. Offer your gratitude to the lotus feet of Paramahamsa Nityananda. Pratyaksha Pada Puja is a rare opportunity in a lifetime to express your surrender and gratitude directly at the feet of the Master, daily at 7 a.m. IST. You can register for E-Pada Puja online. You can receive individual darshan and blessings after the puja. You can send your blessings request to ntv@nityananda.org or call 919742203311. Make the best use of this rare opportunity to be in the space of the living enlightened master.
Samyama has to be practiced, applied in progression. I do not want to use the word stages. No, stage by stage. No. It has to be applied in progression. Please understand. It means there's a big difference between stage by stage and progression. Stage by stage means it's like you are supposed to achieve something stage by stage, step by step. No. I wanted to tell you all, Samyama is like taking out something which you already have in your treasury box, treasure vault, wallet, taking it out in progression. It means, see, please understand, if you translate that very word, that one word, Bhumishu Viniyogaha, this is a technical term. The sacred secret is hidden in these two words. Bhumishu Viniyogaha. If you translate and understand that word as stage by stage, you get a feeling, it's like you need to achieve something. No. Even if you think your body and mind
please understand, you don't need to achieve anything. There is already enough treasures in your vault, in your treasury box, in your inner space. You only need to take them out in progression. Stage is different, progression is different. So technically I will translate this word Bhumishu Viniyogaha as progression, then stage by stage. Please understand, God is not ultimate. In Yoga Vedantic tradition, God is a stepping stone for enlightenment. God is a concept used for you to experience godliness. The ultimate possibility for every human being in spiritual field is thrown open only in Vedic tradition, because everything is a technique for you to experience the highest. There is no definitive higher or superior power over you. Even the concept of God is for you to experience godliness. The moment you translate the word stage by stage, it gives the feeling like you need to achieve something. No, you don't need to. Take the responsibility to only get something out of your treasury. You don't need to yearn. As long as you have the idea you need to achieve, you always feel there is somebody who is having it. Somebody who is possessing it, you need to take it away from that person. Tribal mentality. It is okay for religions in a very primitive state. But not for sophisticated, evolved, luxurious people like Ganges civilization. Understand the vast difference between translating this Bhumishu Viniyoga as stage by stage or progression. A big difference. If you translate that as a stage by stage, still you are stuck with the primitive mentality of religion. Somebody is having, you need to take it. Root cause of all depression. Progression means you have it. Your body and mind need to take that out from your inner space, super consciousness. All you need is training your body and mind step by step to take those things out. Why the word progression, step by step? Because if your body and mind tries to take everything out, all the powers out at a time, it may not be able to stay in a balanced way and express those powers. It may just get burnt away. I have seen sometimes people boiling themselves in depression, burning themselves into negativity. Same way, sometimes people can boil themselves
even with extraordinary powers, if their body and mind is not matured enough to handle these extraordinary powers, they may just play with these powers in a foolish way and disturb and damage, cause too much damage to people. Ramakrishna tells a beautiful story. One sadhu, somehow retrieved the power of stopping the air movement from his inner space. But unfortunately, his body and mind was not matured and he did not do it in progression. Just got the power. So one day there was a intense cyclone. Many boats were getting rocked, disturbed in the river. Out of his power, just like that, he stopped that cyclone. Because of the sudden stop, many boats tumbled, overturned. Many people got drowned and died. And that karma came to him. The power which he had left him. Sometime, when the body and mind is not matured enough and the powers are expressed in your body and mind, it's very dangerous. It is very dangerous. An important thing you need to learn, the meaning of the word Bhumishu Viniyoga, progression, means properly your body and mind need to take those extraordinary powers out of your system through proper samyama. This can happen only if you are part of a mystery school. Only you are with an enlightened being, an incarnation, who clearly balances and guides you and makes that samyama happen in your body and mind. I have seen. Sometimes the masters do something extraordinary to balance people and make these extraordinary powers express through the body and mind. I have read once Vivekananda even making one of his disciples to eat fish. You may think, how fish is going to help in yoga? That guy, a disciple, acquired some extraordinary powers without going through the proper progression. So it may not be right for his body and mind. Please understand. In samyama, I am always saying two part. One, experiencing the great experiences and powers and expressing it. For example, at this moment, I am in a great experience that all the so-called reality in front of me is made of a stuff which I can bend, break, mend, do as I want. This is experience. If I do at least small changes and things and show it in reality, physically, either through simple levitation or through simple teleporting of the vibhuti, it is expression of the power. Please understand. As experience, at this moment, I am feeling anything in front of me is made out of stuff which is completely under my control, part of me. This is my experience. When I share this word, if I ignite this mood in many of you, I am expressing the experience. Same way, this experience brings certain powers, like any body can be moved as I want, any body's kundalini can be raised to the same level I am in, or any material can be moved from one place to another place by the power of the mind. This is extraordinary powers. First one is extraordinary experience, second one is extraordinary power. So if this is shown visibly as the kundalini awakening or the levitation or teleporting, it is expressing extraordinary powers. I wanted both dimensions of samyama to be kept alive. I am going to dedicate my life to reproduce this experience on people, reproduce these great powers on people, and scientifically establish a step by step practical lifestyle where people can experience all these great experiences and powers of samyama and express the great experiences and powers of samyama to the world.
Nitya Kriya, restoring Hatha Yoga to the world. A series of healing yogic processes revealed by Paramahamsa Nityananda to care and cure for diseases and disorders. Practice Nitya Kriya and awaken your kundalini energy. To find out more, visit www.nityananda.org/nitya-kriyas.
All the great miracles, extraordinary powers, expressions you read, study in different masters' lives, enlightened beings' lives, is all these great yogic powers. It is these great yogic siddhis. It is this yogic siddhis which are responsible for creating those miracles. I can say all yogis, all siddhas were not only expressing the extraordinary powers, they also realized the ordinary reality is not reality. Ordinary reality is not reality. Try it on yourself. Do samyama on how the sounds are heard and converted into meaningful words. How the touch is felt, converted into experience of pain or pleasure. How the smell is felt, converted into good or bad. Do samyama on the spot where the conversion happens. Work on the space where that meaning is added to what is. Then you will be very easily able to separate. Actually, you can try this experiment. Take a candy and a green chili, put both on your tongue in two ends. One side touch your tongue with the candy, very sweet candy. Other side with the green chili. Be aware of both. What is happening? How the tongue is responding? Do samyama on it. Suddenly you will realize both excitement is one and the same. It is you who is labeling it. This is hot, this is sweet. This samyama will liberate you, will make you realize, experience, will make you understand how to do samyama on the sound, how to do samyama on the touch, how to do samyama on the scene. Doing samyama on all these five, exactly on the spot, on the space where the cognition happens, where the recognition happens, will lead you to have extraordinary powers and the realization reality is not the ultimate reality. Let me describe the samyama exactly. See very clearly, just above the heart center, in the center, tortoise shaped energy center, light, powerful energy center exists. Tortoise shaped energy center. Visualize that and do samyama on it. Suddenly you will see very thought flow stops. You will feel like your whole body has become like a stone. It has become like a stone. Even if you visualize yourself as become like a stone, only in that place you will not be able to feel you have become stone, like there is no movement. In that place you will always feel there will be movement. Now visualize that Kurmanadi energy center, just little above the heart, as a light, and sit like a huge rock, sit like a huge mountain. Visualize you are stable and powerful like a mountain. Enter into this samyama. Sit in Padmasana. You can hold both the feet through the Koyoni Mudra. Koyoni Mudra means just like this. The hand, you can cross it. Hold the legs in a crossed way. Hold. Sit stably. Feel you are a solid rock, huge mountain, no movement. Visualize the Kurmanadi, small tortoise shaped intense light just above the heart center. Feel you are like a stone, huge mountain. Today's subject, every sound is mantra. Understand? Every sound can lead you to enlightenment. Means, every moment the possibility for enlightenment is open. Sound, what is meant by sound, and consciousness which experiences the sound and what is meant by the sound, the buddhi. Understand? Sound, the purpose, what is meant by the sound, and the space, intelligence, where both are happening. For example, I use the word cow. That is sound. What is meant by the word, that animal, is artha, means the purpose. Where the word cow creates the meaning of the cow picture in your mind, in your inner space. The moment I utter the word cow, immediately in your inner space, that four leg, two horn, one tail, that animal is there. The space where that is happening here is buddhi. Pratyayanam. Please understand. Sabda, artha, pratyayanam. Sound, the purpose or the meaning of the sound, and space where the idea of the sound suddenly happens. Buddhi. These three gets overlapped in life. Please understand. These three gets overlapped in the life. Because it gets overlapped, whole life is a confusion. Now, start doing samyama on these three. When you do samyama on these three, the first thing will happen is you will understand all these three are separate. You will experience the gap between these three. First thing. Second, any sound, you will know the meaning. For example, now, few minutes before, whether, I don't know whether you observed or not, a dog barked outside. The sound came. Actually, the sound is, when you hear the sound, oh, dog barks, that's all. You do not know the meaning. I know the meaning. The dog has a liver problem. If you catch the dog and check, you will find it has a liver problem and digestion problem. If you tell the housekeeping people to catch the dog and check the dog, it will have a liver problem and digestion problem. We can prove it. Understand, when you do samyama on the sound, you know the meaning of it. When all the three are separate, the sound, meaning, the space where both are happening, our connection is happening. When there is a gap between these three, means clarity between these three, suddenly you know the deeper meanings and happening behind the sound. You will know the meaning of sounds created by animals, sounds created by the trees, sounds created by the stones. If you want to know the language of birds, want to know the language of animals, want to know the language of trees, want to know the language of nature, want to understand, do samyama on this sound. This will give you extraordinary powers. That's the first thing. Second thing, this samyama
will give you the meaning of the cosmic sound Om and make you enlightened. Understand? Patanjali is a great master. He picks up very tasty roots. Not only the roots lead you to enlightenment, even on the way you will have some beautiful, extraordinary powers which continuously encourages you. Patanjali knows the human psychology. Samyama is powerful path for enlightenment. You need some extraordinary powers, inspiring, exciting things in your life for you to continue to practice. I tell you, experience with this. Now I am giving you the exact technique. Actually, this samyama, if you practice, it will directly heal all the disease related to your eyes and hearing. Please understand, in medical science, ear, nose, throat is connected. But actually in yogic science, ears and eyes are connected. As per the science of the nadi, ears and eyes are directly linked. Ear, eye and the power of speaking. These three are directly linked. Not ENT. E-E-S. Speaking power. Hearing, seeing and speaking. All three powers are directly related to Ajna Chakra. Third eye. That is why I am telling you, when you learn speaking and enrolling people for certain ideas, you will have developed hearing and your eyesight will be clear. This samyama directly will help you to clear the problems related to your hearing, eyesight and ability to speak. If you have the stammering during speaking or stage fear, please understand, in the whole world the stage fear is, people are having, more number of people are having stage fear than the death fear. If you ask what is the worst fear, it is not death fear, it's a stage fear. All the three problems can be solved, healed with this samyama. I'll give you the exact samyama. Sit and feel your inner space is the screen on which the sounds come and hit and make the meaning. Understand? Your inner space is a conscious eardrum. In the eardrum, you know, sound comes and hits and the meaning is made. But your inner space is, sound comes and hits, not only meaning is made, you can witness both the sound and the meaning. Understand? Don't hear just in your eardrums. Hear through your Anandaganda. Now, when a sound comes, see, now when a sound hits you, what you do? It hits your eardrum and meaning is made and actions are taken. Don't do that. Sit, have restful awareness for the sound to hit your Anandaganda. Make any meaning or response to any sound in your Anandaganda. For example, now when you sit, you are hearing the fan sound. You are hearing this small tuk-tuk-tuk sound from the roof. Make all this meaning in your Anandaganda.
When you sit like that, you will start hearing some bird sound. You will have meaning for that bird sound happening in you. Not only that, if your spouse, even if he or she is just breathing, from that breathing sound you know what mood she is in. What mood he is in. Sometime you will see, you will send a strong letter, or you may not even send a letter, you may just ask my secretary, I wanted to meet Swamiji. I'll say, no, now I am not interested in meeting. Because now I know you are not interested in listening to me. You are interested only in fighting with me. I'll just avoid meeting. But sometime you will not even be asking to talk to me. When I walk, I'll ask, hey, what is going on? Anything to tell me? Means you are interested in listening to me. Just by the breathing sound, you know what mood the other person is in. It's an extraordinary siddhi. You can receive and send message from both corners of the river. Understand? Sending and receiving message through nature was our telecommunication system. You can send, receive informations, understand the meanings of the birds, animals, rocks. When you go deeper, you can just listen the eternal cosmic sound and meaning of the sound, the cosmos and the space where it is happening is your inner space. It means you are enlightened. Understand? First step, try to listen sounds from your Anandaganda. See, your Anandaganda is a conscious eardrum where a sound comes and hits, meaning is made, but you are watching both. The buddhi, where the sound is hitting and meaning is happening, is a third entity. Be aware of all these three, that's all. Whenever you find time, and if you are interested in this samyama, take up this samyama. Understand? This samyama will directly lead to physical healing of hearing, seeing, and talking problems, give you the extraordinary siddhis of understanding the language of animals and nature. Third, ultimately enlightenment itself by experiencing the cosmic sound, Nada Brahma. Sirasasana and Sarvangasana will help this samyama. And Mahamantra means the intense humming will help this samyama. Mahamantra technique will help this samyama. And Sambhavi Mudra can help this samyama. Please understand. So I can give as a technique this samyama. First, do Shirasasana and Sarvangasana, then do 7 minutes of intense humming, then 21 times of Sambhavi Mahamudra, then sit and do this samyama as long as you can. You will experience the maximum benefit of this samyama and experience extraordinary siddhis.
Kailash, the abode of Shiva. Explore the peak of mystery with Paramahamsa Nityananda, a living enlightened master to the most sacred pilgrimage destination on earth. Added bonus, a visit to Madurai is added to the itinerary of the full trip with Swamiji after returning from Kailash. For more information or to register, visit n-yatras.nityananda.org or write us at n.yatras@nityananda.org.
Let me give you the deepest meaning of this word prana and apana. Constantly in you, for a moment you remember you exist, and after a few moments you forget you exist, and your mind starts wandering here and there. Try this process. Try to just sit and remember about you. Just though, I exist, I remember me, I exist, I remember me. Just the self-remembrance. Try the self-remembrance. In few seconds you will forget. Please understand. The moments you remember yourself is prana. The moments you forget you exist is apana. Unless you forget you exist, you can't remember you exist. Unless you remember you exist, you won't forget you exist. The prana and apana live together. But how mercury slowly absorbs the gold? Prana can absorb apana. If mercury and gold is kept near, if they are touching each other, mercury will swallow the gold and gold will lose its qualities into the mercury. Same way, if the prana is allowed to function, means if the self-remembrance is increased by your conscious will, if you are supporting the self-remembrance by your conscious decision, it will swallow the apana part, the self-forgetting moments. Please understand, a most subtle Vedantic truth, most subtle spiritual truth, if you try to remember yourself, constantly be in the unclutching or remembrance of the higher self, only if you try you will understand what I am saying. Just remembering, I exist, I am, I exist, I am here, I feel me, yes, I am alive, I remember me, I am. If you just remember you, that self-remembrance, for some people that self-remembrance will be there without disturbance, maybe for 3 seconds, for some it will be 10 seconds. Usually none of you will have more than 12 seconds. That is the maximum for a normal conscious being. By the time one flicker of thought will come. If somebody can establish themselves in the self-remembrance for 21 seconds, he is enlightened, Jivan Mukta. 21 seconds is a too long period to be established in that self-remembrance. Then your mind breaks, you become a liberated being. This self-remembrance, when you are trying, the thoughts which come because of your forgetfulness, due to your forgetfulness, the forgetfulness is apana, remembrance is prana, forgetfulness is apana. Now, you are not supposed to hate apana. Constantly you create a guilt in you, I forget, the forgetfulness happens to me, I don't remember, I am not qualified. You are constantly worrying and struggling with apana. Stop it. Work on prana.
Whenever you remember, understand it is a luck, bonus, gift. Celebrate prana. Celebrate the moments of self-remembrance. Stop feeling guilty. Stop suffering. Stop suffocating yourself for the moments of forgetfulness. All this name, form, time, space, everything will just dissolve into yourself. That is the Advaita Anubhuti, the ultimate experience. I tell you, if the self-remembrance, if you are struggling between self-remembrance and self-forgetfulness, that zone is Dvaita. If that struggle has reduced and the self-remembrance has become more powerful than the forgetfulness, that is called Visishta Advaita. If the self-remembrance has conquered the forgetfulness, that is Advaita. That's all. Understand? If you are suffering the self-remembrance and self-forgetfulness, if there is a struggle going on, that is Dvaita. I am separate, ultimate is separate, the gap. If the self-remembrance has become more powerful than the forgetfulness, the self-remembrance is more than 51%, it is less than 49%. Now it is Visishta Advaita. It is me, but extension of me. I am he, but extension of he. When the self-remembrance becomes 100%, it is Advaita. That's all. Please understand. Just support your prana consciously. When I say support your prana consciously, I mean constantly try to establish yourself in these three. Enchanting, feeling connection, unclutching. Constantly take this up as a spiritual practice from today. Whole day your body should be working. Means you can sweep, wipe, cook, drive. Whole day your body should be engaged in your regular activities. Reading, even sleeping is activity. Engage yourself in some activity. Or lie down and sleep. Even sleeping is activity, no problem. But along with your activity, establish yourself into these three. Whole day, the moment you wake up, start the ajapa japa. Ajapa japa starts. And then feeling connection with a deep prayerful mood. Unclutching. The feeling connection is the bridge between unclutching and ajapa japa. Constantly do this. Only condition, you cannot have guilt about the forgetfulness. In the whole day, 24 hours, even if you remember the self-remembrance only 10 minutes, that is okay, celebrate about that. Do not have guilt about that forgetfulness, because if you create guilt about that forgetfulness, you unnecessarily empower the wrong side. The apana becomes more strong. So support, encourage, inspire, prana means moments of self-remembrance. Try. Do some work. Along with that, you will be doing these three. Enchanting, feeling connection, unclutching. EFU. EFU. Enchanting, feeling connection, unclutching. Constantly do this, all these three. You are capable of doing all these three simultaneously. You are capable. You are capable of doing all these things simultaneously. So please understand, this 21 days, this samyama will be called as prana samyama, encouraging and empowering the self remembrance inside you, the power of prana inside you. Try this prana samyama for 21 days, EFU, enchanting, feeling connection, unclutching. Enlightenment is for you. EFU.
Now, Patanjali is talking an important truth. He is revealing a very important sacred secret. He says, all the samyamas he gave till now, and all the powers, extraordinary powers and experiences will happen, are great achievement in the outer world, but obstacle to the samadhi state.
Patanjali, the scientist extraordinaire, goes on describing various samyamas, not only for you to experience those powers, to remind you the signboards which happen on the way, on the process, when you experience, when you go through, when you go in, you experience many signboards. Those signboards can be an encouraging paths, points, or can be an obstruction if you are standing stuck with it. Please understand, it can be an encouraging signboard. For example, you sit in Bangalore station in train to go to Delhi, continuously seeing various stations which are supposed to come before Delhi, and the board, way to Delhi, or this many kilometers to Delhi. These boards can do two jobs. The scenes can do two jobs. One, it can be encouraging you. You are on the track. You will reach Delhi. You will reach the goal. Or sometime people who are stuck in ignorance and foolishness, it can be diversion. They may think they reached Delhi and get down. I am all for the extraordinary experiences and powers you go through during the samyama process. But I wanted to remind you continuously, don't stop there. Don't get down there. Don't create self-sympathy. Oh, I have done this much for my background. You will have your own mind drama. See, I am such an ordinary guy. I struggled so much and achieved the level where I can have one or two siddhis. It's too much. Enough. This self-sympathy creates tremendous fatigue, tiredness, idea of almost you are full. No. Fulfillment happens in a space where there is no mind to feel fulfillment. Peace happens in a space where there is no mind to feel the peace. I tell you,
a basic rule, a law for the enlightenment. It is continuous expansion. Continuous expansion. And I want all of you to know, Patanjali or any Vedic tradition does not speak about enlightenment. Then what are we doing? It is Buddha's contribution. Enlightenment idea itself is the contribution of Buddha. I want you to be very clear. In Vedic tradition, we don't have goal of enlightenment. Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana. That's all. Listening, internalizing, expressing. That's all. Means what? The expression goes on and on and on and on. There is no space where the boat says you have arrived. No. It goes on and on and on. The mind which always wants, expects the boat, you have arrived, where it disappears, explodes, that spot can be called as enlightenment. That is what Buddha defines as enlightenment. Enlightenment is not destination, it is part of destiny.
Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bangalore, 562-109. Contact 0974-220-331. www.nityananda.org.
Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experiences.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapitam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.